Hey there, fellow Meta Horizon Worlds creators. Do you see what's going on behind me? Today we'll embark on an epic journey to master the art of using code blocks to elegantly oscillate objects, or in my case, a UFO, on a vertical plane. Let's not dilly-dally and get straight to the juicy bits. With the aid of my tutorial, we'll dive into the depths of this mesmerizing concept together. The fundamental principle at play here is the harmonious interplay between mathematics and programming. It's a marriage made in heaven, or in this case, the metaverse. Let's dive in and discover the secrets behind this mesmerizing phenomenon and take our creations to new heights. Let's get cracking and oscillate our way to glory. Okay, here we are with a Meta Horizon Worlds code blocks script window. Let's give our script its name, Oscillating Objects. We will create the variables that we know we will need for this animation. We are going to be manipulating the object's Y and Z axis in this case. So let's create a Y number variable and a Z number variable. I'm also going to create a Y radius number variable, which I will set to a default of 16. And a Z radius number variable, which I will set to 5. Now you can change these later on. This will change the path that your object oscillates over. So 16 on the Y and 5 on the Z axis should give us an oval path for the object to travel. Next, we'll need a frequency number variable. I'm going to set that to 2. And we will also need an angle variable, which is a number that will be used internally. That's it for the number variables. Create also an enabled Boolean and an original position vector. Great. When world is started, let's send an event called post start to ourself after a 2-second delay. I'll explain why I do this in just a moment. Let's handle that post start event. So when post start is received, let's set the original position vector variable that we created to the position of our object. Now we're going to attach this script to the object that we're oscillating, so we can call this self. We don't have to create a separate variable for that object. While we're here in the post start, let's go ahead and set the enabled Boolean to true. Alright, we will need an onUpdate block, and we can leave that at default. Inside that, we will use an if to check to see if our enabled Boolean is true. If it is, we can set our Y variable that we created. And let's get a couple of operators to calculate that Y. I'm going to add an addition operator and a multiplication operator. So this line should read, set y to the y of the original position plus the y radius multiplied by the cosine of angle. All right, let's do the same thing for the z axis. So set z those operators again, an addition operator and a multiplication operator. This time we'll say set z to the z axis of original position plus the z radius multiplied by the sine of angle. Okay, now we can move ourself to a new vector from x, y, z. We want to keep our object on the x plane, so we're not going to change the x plane from its original position, but we are updating its y plane and its z plane. And the last thing we need to do is increment that angle variable. So let's set angle, and I'm going to use a few more operators to calculate this. I will use the modulo operator. To the left of the modulo, I need an addition operator and a multiplication operator. To the right of the modulo, I need a multiplication operator. All right, now make this line read set angle to angle plus delta time multiplied by frequency modulo pi multiplied by 2. Okay, so quick recap. When world is started, we are going to send a post-start event to ourselves after 2 seconds. When that post-start event is received, we will store our object's original position, and we will enable our animation. On update, when the animation is enabled, we are going to calculate a new y position for the object based on the cosine of an angle. And we are also calculating a new z position for the object based on the sine of that angle. Here we move the object to the new vector that we just created. And we increment angle by just a little bit for the next loop, making sure that it doesn't exceed 2 pi. All right, let's jump over into Horizon and see this in action. Okay, here we are back in Meta Horizon Worlds. We have our oscillating objects script that we've just created. I've gone ahead and attached that script to my UFO object. I've given it a Y radius of 5 and a Z radius of 16. That will basically give me an oval shape. All right, let's go ahead and start the world and see the UFO in action. And there we go. That's all it takes to create a oscillating UFO in Meta Horizon Worlds. All right, well, that's it for today, fellow creators. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial on oscillating objects in Meta Horizon Worlds using code blocks scripting. Programming may seem daunting at first, but with practice and patience, anyone can master it. Also, don't forget to follow me on Facebook and Instagram for more updates. All of my social media accounts are linked in the video description. If you enjoyed this video and would like to see more Horizon Worlds scripting tutorials, please be sure to subscribe to my channel. And if you would like to support me, you can check out my Patreon page linked in the description below. If you found this tutorial helpful, please be sure to give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment below. I would love to hear about your own creations and other ideas you have for future tutorials. And if you haven't already, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and click the notification bell to stay updated with all things Shadal VR creates. Thank you so much for joining me today, and until next time, keep exploring, keep creating, and keep having fun in Meta Horizon Worlds. This is Shadal VR signing off. Bye, everyone.